Kurt, you had your first start here last year, an interception, and then you had this big game. What do you like about this field?
I like that we keep winning, and that's the most important thing. But yeah, it's something special to have my first career interception and now three in the game. So it's been a blessing to come down and watch.
The interceptions, were they kind of from like reading Rex Grossman, or how did they kind of come about? It looked like you kind of knew what he was going to do with the ball sometimes.
The first one, they try to stretch us out by running all goes, and I was just reading Rex, and I had a feeling that he was just going to try to hit the tight end because Fred Davis is such a talented tight end, so I was kind of cheating that way, and once he threw it, I had to go and make the play. The other ones, just instincts. I just felt like Rex was going to throw, and I just break it on the ball.
Were you surprised at some of the decisions he was making on those throws?
Was I surprised? It's just one of the things, as a DB, you hope a QB throws it, but you never know if he's going to.
Kurt, you've been waiting all season to kind of take the momentum of the game as a defense and make big plays like that. Finally doing it today, you feel like you took a big step as a defense?
Absolutely. This isn't just me that's up here standing. You know, this is the whole defense. We played as a team, and I really felt like everybody was doing their job. We stopped the run, which is something that we haven't been able to do all year, and I think that's what really pushed them to throw the ball, and which allowed, myself, Nate, the defensive line to get sacks. That's what really, makes the biggest difference is stopping the run.
Kirby, I'm surprised they did so many long passes because they threw a lot of deep stuff.
No, because I think, they love to throw deep passes on play action, and then, they like to make mismatches. The first one was they thought they had a mismatch with the linebacker, with Fred Davis. But, like I said, I was cheating that way and just kind of read the QB on the throw.
Kurt, how tough was it originally being taken out of the starting lineup, and how good did it feel, obviously, to be back here?
It's tough. I'm a competitor, and I know what I'm capable of doing out there. But, the first three games, I wasn't getting it done, and that was apparent. And I think it was a humbling experience. God taught me a lesson, and, I just worked my butt off the last couple weeks, and, now that I got my opportunity, I want to make the best of it.
Is there something that clicked into place as a result of getting pulled from the starting line?
Clicked into place? I was playing my game. I just wasn't doing enough, so to speak. And I think today, along with the defensive line, stopping the run, I was able to be back there and make the plays like that I have been in my whole career.
What did you guys do? The run defense, did you tighten it up a little bit? The front?
Our emphasis this whole week, leading up to it, we stopped the run. We realized that we were 30th in the National League, stopping the run. And I think everybody put an emphasis on doing your part, controlling your gaps and making the plays. And I thought we tackled, very well today. Limited runs. And I don't know if they had any big runs today.
Juan Castillo's taking a ton of heat leading into this game. How good do you feel for him after he's going through?
Juan's a great coach. He really is, and he puts his heart and soul into every single week. And I wish you guys could see what he does in the background. He really cares about us, and he wants nothing but the best. And I think he tries to put us in the best position. It's unfortunate that the first couple of weeks, it hasn't gone our way. But now, as you see, when things start to click, things start to roll. So I think if we can build on this, every week, we'll be in a fine shape.
When's the last time you had three interceptions in a game?
High school.
Were you senior, junior?
Junior.
Listen, did you yet that, no Eagle has done this since you were born?
Say it again.
Has it hit you yet that no Eagle had done this since you were born?
Since before I was born?
66.
I really don't get into that. I just go out there and have fun. And I thank the Lord that I was able to, make the plays. But, I want to have three interceptions every game. That's my goal. And I want to continue to build on this. This team needs to build on this and continue to get better and better. We want to take this one game at a time. We know we have a long road to go. But if we continue to play like we do today, things will start rolling our way.
You had a lot of safety combinations that you and Jared in there. How nice would it be just to be able to have two people consistently play at the same time?
I think that's what we wanted all along, from the beginning of the camp. But, when you have a new defense, when we're trying to find the right fits for our safeties and, right schemes and how we want to play things, hopefully this is the right combo. Nate and I have a very good relationship on and off the field, and we know where each other are going to be, and I think we have a nice chemistry back there. We get things lit up.
Kurt, two more guys?
Did the corners play a little bit more man today?
Not really. We actually ran a lot of things that we've been running this whole week. But I think we had a lot tighter coverage. And we expected our corners to, man up in the development of the routes. It turns into a lot of mans. So, when that happens, we expect a lot of our corners. There's times where they're in the island. A couple of deep balls, Sante. But Sante is one of the best corners in the league. And, he allows us. With him manning up, we can play down the box and stop the run. So, that's why we pay him the big bucks.
Kurt, you mentioned being able to cheat over on at least one of the interceptions. Is there something you saw on film during the week or any extra time in the film room to kind of let it recognize it?
I did put more time in the film room because, you know, this ship needed to be right, you know, this week. We needed to get this win. I think everybody put in a little bit extra time because, you know, we were right there. We just needed to put that extra, you know, to get it over in the hump. And, you know, if we can continue to put in the extra work, you know, every week, we'll be fine. You know, I think talent-wise, we're up there with anybody. But, you know, if we don't go out there and do our job each and every week, you know, we're going to lose.
Okay, thank you, guys.